different way to look at work so you don't be afraid of work. A lot of people are afraid of work, which is why your income is staying the same, because you're afraid of work. But if you just looked at the true meaning of work, it might change your perspective of work. Work doesn't necessarily mean that you're gonna sweat every single hour and bleed and cry and moan and be in pain and have back pains and all this stuff. That, no, there's a component of that where you're being tested and you're going through obstacles in different seasons. Yeah, totally get it. But the true meaning of work is to become. If I become who I am, then I can only from there be at my highest potential. If I'm at my highest potential, then I'm at my highest capability to be paid at the highest rate possible according to my spiritual gifts and talents. It's fact, done deal, okay? Different way of looking at the word work, 2,600 hours. So you minus the 2,628 and the 2,600 hours, and then you throw in sleep, okay? I think the average person gets roughly 8 hours of sleep a day. So I went off that number. It's 2,920 hours, okay? So in my case, I use another 10% of my time to expand, right? To delegate my work so that I can have more hours for God, family, and me. Continues to increase it. Or I dedicate hours to expand the hours, bringing in people to do what I do, if not better, or preparing people to do good works, righteous works, you name it. So 8,760 minus 2,628. Take that right off the top, minus $2,600, 2,600 hours of work, minus 876 hours of expansion. I'm left with 2,656 hours. Divide that. Shoot, what did I do? I know that it comes out to roughly 7.2 hours. Let me just run that real quick. So verify that, 876, boom. Yeah, then divide that. 36. Yep. So 7.2 hours is my average sleep time that I get personally. Obviously, some days is more, some days is less. Average. When you know where your time is going, you know where you can pull from to either start a new project, start a new business, to create more income. When you create more income, you get back more time in your life. If you're able to walk away from a 40, 50 hour life-sucking paycheck and then redirect that 40 hours times 52 weeks back into your cycle, boom. Then you're able to calculate. And then in many cases, there's time that we waste. So to be fully transparent, probably between this 2628 and this 876, in reality, when it actually plays out, I'm pretty sure a good maybe 5 to 10% of these two numbers and even my work goes to waste, right? So I'm pretty sure the average person will waste about a good 1,000 hours a year of their time, probably more. The reason why you can prove this is you can literally search up the average amount of time people watch TV. I can guarantee you it's at least above 3 hours. It's probably more than that. So if it's 4 hours times 365, that's 1400 hours on average people are wasting. So oftentimes when you're trying to increase your income, you run into a problem of maybe not cash, but time. You're like, I don't have any time, Denzel, I've got three kids and I have this and I have that and that and that. And I'm like, what did he say on House of, what is it? Atlanta Housewives, Orange County, right? Like, I'll test you if you ever try to give me excuses as to why you can't or can do something, why you can or can't do something. And I'll be like, did you catch the last episode of Below Deck or Housewives of Orange County, Atlanta? What's the other Housewives? They're up north, them wannabes, you know? And then you got the basketball wives. So when I'm talking to my single moms, divorced moms, widow moms, married moms, I'll challenge you if you start having conversations with me about increasing your income. Like, hey, you gotta give that up. That's all crap. It's programming your mind, right? To be lazy, dumb, stupid, and not think for yourself. It's killing your critical thinking skills when you just sit at a TV all day and you binge watch the next thing on Netflix. Like, oh my God, I gotta catch that episode of, you know, the freaking, what is it? The sex education, that was a big one that came out. And you get all these murder episodes, you know, where there's such a fixation on the guy that murders people. And then there's the fixation on the guy that rapes women and abuses the kids. And I'm like, people, you know what you're programming your mind with all day long is sex, murder, deception, greed, manipulation, deceit, stealing. No wonder why you can't come up with a strategy to increase your income. No wonder why you're struggling to put two and two together to determine whether or not velocity banking makes sense for your situation. No wonder why you struggle so much to comprehend infinite banking. No wonder, because you've programmed your mind over the last God knows how many years of watching Housewives and Below Deck and the freaking, you know, the HDTV. They're showing you the fix and flips, all the cool houses that they buy. You're like, oh my God, I want that. Let's go make it happen. Instead of watching it, how about we go do it? Yes? So this is a call to action. Everybody here, and then those catching the replay, and those that I'll talk to later and I'll show them this video. Like, hey, you wanna go? Let's go. But it's gonna cost you your favorite episode, your favorite TV series, your movies. It's gonna cost you that. To me, that's no cost at all. So for the men, the football, the basketball, the baseball, the soccer, the freaking fantasy league, the freaking ESPN, the freaking, the fishing, you know, that you do on the weekends and you go shoot guns at the gun range. I got nothing against none of that. Nothing against it. It becomes a problem when it consumes you. And then now you're doing it to either impress someone, impress upon, right? You're doing it to keep up with the Joneses next door, and it's sucking your cash flow and time. No wonder why you struggle getting your family out of debt, and you're supposed to be the head of the household. No wonder why you can't come up with a business plan to provide for your wife and your kids. No, your wife now has to go to work because you're clowning around watching ESPN and football and the Super Bowl. I can't tell you. I don't even know who won the Super Bowl last year. I don't know who's going to the Super Bowl this year. None of that is of concern to me. You know what's going to end up happening is I dedicate so much time to increasing my knowledge, wisdom, network, net worth, helping people, that I guarantee you that years from now, I'll be invited, top of the line, full expenditures taken care of, best suite in the house, probably sit with the owner of the team that goes to the Super Bowl because I helped his son, daughter, nephew, cousin, brother, sister, mom even, dad even. And he's like, hey Denzel, by the way, I own the Dallas Cowboys, or I'm a part owner in, you know, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers or the Miami Dolphins. Why don't you bring your girl, you know, your kids, you know, say I got kids later and wife. Why don't you bring your family down? Listen, I got front row seats. Matter if we got the box seats. You know how likely that is to happen? You know how more likely it is for those types of situations to occur when you're walking in your purpose? So if I just release my attention from what is distracting me, even though I may like those things and I might find it fun and entertaining, what's even more entertaining is getting to be on the set of the production of your favorite show. What's even more exciting is being able to talk to the actors, you know, and go to the football games and go meet the housewives and Below Deck, actually be on a show of Below Deck or on HDTV because I'm remodeling a big old home and they're gonna come in and they're gonna do this whole thing and I'm gonna get the property brothers to do it. Isn't that more exciting, more exhilarating than to just be a spectator and never actually experience it? Like, come on, right? So I say all that to put the pressure on you. It's 2022. If you are still in this I don't know phase, you have got to wake up.